Good evening, Lake Orion. Welcome to History Now here on ONTV. I'm your host, Anthony Taormina, and I got a special guest with me today, Mr. Sean Charette. Sean, Lake Orion class of 2012 graduate, also currently playing for Grand Valley State University. Sean, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Sean, you are very well known in the Lake Orion community. I want to talk about briefly your life, how you grew up, and also how you overcame a lot of adversity in the elementary and middle school, and also even the high school.
Growing up, I grew up with parents who got divorced when I was at a very young age, so I was kind of going back and forth. Mm-hmm. I grew up actually playing hockey for the majority of my life, really. And after that, I feel like the adversity I kind of had was growing up through very private schools, Catholic schools. I went to Everest Academy, mm-hmm. and then moved to St. Joe's for a few years. Mm-hmm. And then the transition from St. Joe's to a public school from Oakview, then to the high school. So, mm-hmm. I mean, really, I kind of breached out a little bit, kind of got to know some people, and became friends with them, and kind mm-hmm. of started from there. So adversity really didn't hit me until maybe later mid-high school. So
it felt like Oakview, obviously Oakview was the first time that we met, because mm-hmm. you were at the time runner on the Oakview track team.
Right.
Can you mention what that experience was like?
Oh, that was great. Had a great time with Coach Z. Of course, mm-hmm. he always brings a lot of fun to the team, to the squad. Got to learn and meet a lot of new faces, see a lot of new people. So it was fun. It was a good experience for sure.
Because obviously a lot of people talk about Coach Z as being a mentor to many of the kids. And, Coach Z used to coach at Scripps when I was a thrower at Scripps. And Z's been a mentor. And you mentioned that you talked about high school. Can you share with us your experiences in high school?
High school started off young with football and everything. Just Coach Bell kind of gave me a great opportunity at a young age to kind of get in there and run the role for the football team. The teachers were very helpful in mm-hmm. adapting to the new transition of high school and everything. And a lot of new faces, especially going from a middle school to a school with 2,600 kids is not a big, is a big transition. Mm-hmm. So, but it was fun. I had a good time. Met great new friends, the friendships that are going to last lifetime. So I was very fortunate to go to high school at Lake Orion.
One thing I noticed when you went to school or went to high school was you were very, very well known. How hard was it for you to establish those friendships, especially early on? Because it seemed like, when you go from school to school to school, mm-hmm. it becomes very difficult.
Right.
And you come in, you get all these friends here right from the start. How did that click?
You know what? It was kind of more of a personal thing where I had to, keep a good head on my shoulders, show these people, every single person, who I am individually, and let them get to know me a little bit. Kind of not really, stand off to other people and then only be good friends with these people. I reached out to everybody, was the same to everybody, didn't really treat anybody different. That was kind of my way of adapting and kind of meeting new people, learning, different customs of what they do and everything, and kind of getting to know them, so.
One thing that I noticed, and we made mention of this briefly, I've not heard anyone say a bad thing about you. That is quite an amazing accomplishment, quite an amazing compliment. How do you feel about those friendships now? I mean, now you are in college.
Right.
Have you made a goal like I did, for example? I made a goal to keep my friendships from high school and hope to establish them throughout college, and I still talk to many of them today. Do you have that same goal?
Oh, 100%. I just feel like my buddies, they haven't changed a lot. And even seeing them coming back home and spending time with them, like just same old, nothing has really changed. So just good friends, always good friends with great personalities. So I've been very fortunate over the years to meet some very, very amazing people.
Are you still the same Sean Charette you were back in high school?
I mean, I hope so. That could be somebody else's decision or opinion, but I mean, I hope so.
I want to mention one thing briefly. Your mother, Patty, has been very, very instrumental. I also go briefly about your dad, too. He's been very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
How's that been like with having a great relationship with both your parents?
That's huge. It starts with family, and they're all I got, really. I'm an only child. My mom has been absolutely amazing over the years, mm-hmm. with football and everything. She's just been loving it and embracing it. And she's such a huge aspect of this community, and you never see her without a smile on her face, and that just gives me motivation and gives me drive to keep pushing forward through no matter what obstacles I have, just to think about her and how she can have an amazing attitude and everything, you know, every little obstacle mm-hmm. that she comes across, and she pushes through it with a smile on her face. Mm-hmm. Same with my dad, always having a good, you know, personality, always having a good humor. Really, really helped me with the football aspect also of becoming a quarterback. So I owe everything to him, everything.
You've overcome a lot. I often hear students talk about you being a leader and being a mentor. How does that feel about you being seen as a mentor and a leader and a role model?
You know, I mean, I'm honored, really, to hear that and to know people out there that can look at me that way. I just, like I said, there's always room for improvement. There's always room to, you know, become the best of what you can be. And I still haven't even reached that point, or not even close to that point. But keeping a good head on your shoulders, really, I feel like is the main thing. And coming from humble beginnings is where I'll always stand.
That's awesome. Proud of you.
Thank you.
When we return to history now, we're going to bring up Lake Orion football and Sean Charette. Here on History Now, here on ONTV. Welcome back to History Now here on ONTV. I'm here with my guest, Sean Charette. Sean, how you doing?
Good.
I almost called you a host for a minute there.
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, I want to talk about something that is dear to your heart, Lake Orion football.
Good deal.
That line again. All right. 2008, Lake Orion was going into that season having graduated a very good quarterback in Chris Lum.
Mm-hmm. Very good quarterback.
And there was a lot of uncertainty with the quarterback position.
Mm-hmm.
You moved up to varsity immediately. There was some people that were skeptical about it. Not gonna lie, I was skeptical about it first. Mm-hmm. Sammy was skeptical about it first.
Agreed.
Bill Brown, Mr. Reese.
Me.
Yeah, you and yourself. But it started off the game, or it was against Rockford at Eastern Michigan.
Mm-hmm.
You were splitting time with Derek Coe, great man, great quarterback as
awesome.
Well.
Awesome, yep.
What was that experience like going into Rockford at Eastern Michigan, arguably against one of the state's best teams at the time, and a freshman quarterback coming in there and holding his own against one of the best teams in the state?
Really, seriously, all I can think about was the play ahead. I really didn't think too much about the game. I really didn't think too much about the opponent because that was thinking too much. And for me at that age, at that time, that's too much for someone to handle. Mm-hmm. So all I thought about was the play on the wristband and the line ahead of me and the play that had to be done. So
now throughout the season, you did share time, but then you eventually became the starter.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things, the most momentable of those season was the infamous 5 weeks of hell, they call it. Playing Rochester Adams, playing Clarkston, playing Utica Eisenhower, playing Romeo, playing Sterling Heights Stevenson. We'll talk about Forts in a little bit.
Okay.
That's a different one. But, but what was that experience like for a freshman quarterback having to play those five teams? I mean, those five teams.
They were great teams.
And what was that experience like for you?
I mean, it was a thrill. It was absolutely a thrill. I loved every second of it, and I loved marching in there with, you know, the Lake Orion Army that we had at that time. Just, we had outstanding camaraderie, though. I feel like that was the biggest thing. It didn't matter who was put in front of us that year. We were going to play for each other. We were going to win for each other, really. And I mean, they were absolutely amazing teams, too, for sure. But we just had a game plan. We had a game plan that we're going to play hard, play for each other. And then, you know, if somebody stops us, it's they're going to have to give it their all. So
then after getting through that 5 weeks, you had to play the Dearborn Fordson, who is number one in the state.
The Tractors, that's right.
Number one in the state.
That's right.
Aye, aye, aye. But then beat Fordson handily.
Right.
What's your experience about that one? Because that was a lopsided one.
That was cold. That was a cold game, for
sure. I know
sure.
That's cold.
But, I mean, really, we, like I said, we just had a game plan of one team at a time, one play at a time. We knew we had to run the ball just because of their defense and how they played. So Brandon Oaks had a terrific game that game.
Right.
And our offensive line blocked, you know, beautifully, of course. So really, like I said, just kind of taking it one game at a time and didn't really see them as a huge factor for us. So
you made mention one game at a time, state championship game as a freshman. You were being called the Fab Freshman. you were being called arguably the best freshman quarterback that the state has seen in a long, long time. Obviously, was what people were saying in the back of your mind, you just tried to brush it off, outside of Sammy?
Tell you the truth, I haven't heard those things until now. So, like I said, I really tried to not hear, you know, the publicity and trying to hear the hype, because that's not what it's about. It's about your team. It's about your teammates.
Family.
It's about family, exactly, and having camaraderie. So that's all I thought about in those games. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, hearing those things, you know, I'm flattered, I'm honored, and I'm very humbled by them. But I was fighting for my team then.
2009, your sophomore year, despite the record, your development continued. Did you notice any changes your sophomore year from your freshman year as a quarterback and as a leader?
Sophomore year, I feel like there was still amazing athletes on the field. We still had the coaching staff, amazing coaching staff. For a quarterback, I did have to grow up a little, have to be a little bit more verbal in the leadership aspect. But other than that, I just feel like it was learning the offense a little bit better, learning my teammates a little bit more. So having more of a camaraderie to fight for, to play for, having more of a reason. So I feel like that gave us a huge kind of impact in the following years also when we went farther.
Junior year, first game against Oxford. Quite an experience, I will say. I will make mention of the entire season as a whole, before the injury. Junior year, you went in. What's your take about the schedules that Lake Orion had when you were quarterback? Did we just prepare for every team every week? Because they were all, most of them were blowouts quite a bit.
Yeah.
And and was it just good preparing, or was it the schedule, or?
I don't think it was so much the schedule was easy. I think it was our preparation. And if you look at the type of players we had that year, they were just outstanding athletes for sure, but they all fought for each other.
Right.
It all comes back to camaraderie, all comes back to playing for your team. And that very first game, we knew if we wanted to start it off right, we had to fight for it. And we executed every, you know, close to every play, you know, very well. Got up on them quite early too, kind of put a little dagger in them. So, and then after that, we just kind of put the pedal to the metal and didn't stop.
I have to bring up something sad, bad to bring up, the injury.
Oh, yeah.
I have a blare, I mean, because I wasn't at the game, but Sam was there. I remember the injury. And what were your thoughts going in your mind during that injury?
Team. as a team. What's the team going to do? Basically, I couldn't stop because they didn't just look at me as a quarterback. They looked at me as a leader, somebody who had a voice. So I wasn't going to stop just because my ankle stopped.
Right.
I was still going to be there for them. I was still going to, you know, congratulate them. I mean, I've worked all these weeks, and then I'm going to stop there? No, not at all. So I actually had to push harder and find myself even more through that injury just for the team, just so they can push through. So
obviously your leadership, though you weren't on the field, was very important for the Detroit Cath Tech game. Cath Tech was going in that game undefeated, arguably their best team they've ever had, able to prevail on that. What was your advice for Cole Schenzer?
Cole, I mean, there's no advice for Cole, really. I mean, he had his own advice. He's an absolutely amazing player. Really, Cole had a lot of reps throughout the season, so he was ready. And then when he jumped in, I mean, I wasn't surprised at all, just because of the athlete and the type of person he is. He, you know, he got it done for us, and I couldn't be happier.
What was your feeling, Ford Field, back at Ford Field?
Right.
Playing Plymouth, state championship game, Lake Orion wins the state championship. What was your feeling after winning it all? Though, what was your though you were not in there like physically, but you were there with the team and just being there with the team. And what was your feeling like? You're officially a state championship quarterback.
Well, official feeling and the final feeling was the team deserved it. They worked for it. They played every game like they wanted it. And then finally they got it. They deserved it. Another thing, too, the coaches deserved it. They have been absolutely amazing coaches, outstanding play calling through very, very critical games. But, I mean, all I can really come through with is it's very well deserved for the coaches and the players. And, yeah, we had a great team that year, and the camaraderie was just through the roof. So,
senior year. What's it like? What was that experience like? Senior year, you're the incumbent leader of the team. What was your feeling going into senior year for 2011 season?
Senior year kind of came about, and I knew that I had to be more of a leader than anything, just because the next year those kids, I wanted to see the leadership grow. I wanted to kind of know who's going to be the leaders and capitalize them, but tell everybody that everybody has a voice. Everybody has a say in what they do, and you know how they can impact a team just by saying one thing or a couple things. So I just, in a way, kind of was waiting to see what kind of players I had, and then kind of capitalized on being a way of a role model for them to show how to do leadership.
Do you feel that your leadership played a role in the team being as successful as they were the next year in 2012?
I mean, that, like I said, that's kind of all of them. They found their own leaders.
Right.
I wasn't the year for that year, but they had an outstanding year. And what I did see about that team, though, was a lot of heart, a lot of passion, and a lot of love for each other. So the whole camaraderie thing comes back to itself, and it shows there, too.
Right. What's your take about Lake Orion football now?
My take on Lake Orion football is we're still a powerhouse team, still got a great coaching staff. I feel like I would love to come back and coach Lake Orion one day and be a part of this program.
I'd love that.
That would be nice. That would be nice. But I just feel like Lake Orion still has great, great future prospects coming up for him, too. Got a lot of young talent. Got a lot of speed. So it'll be exciting.
Awesome. When we come back to History Now, we're going to talk about Sean and his future with Grand Valley and also the future here on History Now on ONTV. Hello, Lake Orion and Oakland County. This is Sammy Taormina here talking a new show here called OA Now. We're going to talk about sports from football to basketball to volleyball to track and field to soccer, cross country, etc. here on OA Now on ONTV. Welcome back to History Now here on ONTV. I'm your host, Anthony Taormina. I'm accompanied by my partner, Mr. Sean Charette. Sean, how you doing?
Awesome.
I want to talk to you about, you got to play quarterback at Grand Valley. Mm-hmm. What's the experience like at Grand Valley?
Grand Valley's great. Absolutely beautiful campus, beautiful school. Got a great team. Have had absolutely amazing teams in the past too. So, but they run really good program there. So I'm excited to be a part of it.
What's your degree? What are you gunning for at Grand Valley as far as your degree?
Right now I'm in exercise science with a minor pre-med.
Nice.
Want to be a chiropractor.
Nice.
So after I get all my credits, yeah, I'll be off to chiropractic school. So
that'll be fun.
That's the lifelong goal. So I'm not going to stop till I get it. But that's the future a little bit for that. I still want to get a little bit and give back to Lake Orion in a way, no matter what I do or where I go. So that's kind of my future a little bit.
Do you still have a part of Lake Orion in you?
Oh yeah, 100%.
With Grand Valley, what do you see the future for Grand Valley football?
Grand Valley football, like I said, have a lot of great coaches, a lot of great talent too, young talent. So we're going to be good. I feel like we're going to have a really good team around us. Good camaraderie, I feel like, is going to be coming up from the younger players and the older. So that transition can really make the team prosper.
What does the future hold for Sean Charette?
Future holds for me just having a smile on my face and living every day to the fullest, not changing and being happy and learning from my mistakes and also growing from the accomplishments that I do and never looking back.
What would you tell a young Lake Orion boy or girl who is trying to succeed and has seen how you have accomplished so much? What advice would you give to them?
The advice that I would give to them would be smile, for one, because you can't accomplish anything with an empty heart, for one. For two is have a goal, try and reach it, and if that goal doesn't work out, there's more goals. There's more goals to be reached, and in the hardest times, there's always somebody there for you. Always somebody you can call on, your parents, friends, teachers, anybody. Utilize Lake Orion to your fullest and what it's there for, because when you go to Lake Orion, it's really becomes a family. Everybody you meet, everybody you've met in the past, you see them again, you say hi to them like it was just yesterday you were with them. So I say meet as many people as you can, have great friendships with them, and live every day to the fullest.
Awesome. Very, very great advice, Sean. Very, very great advice. Any final thoughts?
No, thank you again for having me on your show, though.
Oh, for sure.
Thank you.
This concludes this episode of History Now here on ONTV. Hey, I would recommend you guys keep on watching those YouTube videos, especially that episode 4 when I talk about my life with Asperger's syndrome. For now, I'm Anthony Taormina, heading on off. Good night, Lake Orion. Have a great night.